sacrifice their health, they sacrifice their mental well-being, just to being able to take care of those guys when they come home from war.
Welcome to a new TV series that's going to help Americans. My Better Medicine.
Born down in a dead man's town, first kick I took was when I hit the ground.
I was on maybe four or five, if not more, different types, pretty heavy medication.
You spend half your life just to cover it.
And, you know, at some point, it just all comes crashing down. And so I was found in the morning, completely unconscious, very weak pulse, just about dead. And it's by the grace of God that, you know, I was found pretty much just in the brink of time.
I received a call from a doctor in a hospital. He said he may not make it through the night.
Went down to see my VA man. He said, son, don't you understand?
I had kidney failure, heart failure, had brain damage. Right when I got out, I had such severe nerve damage.
I have serious spinal degeneration. There's not a day that goes by where there's no pain, and it feels like my lumbar system almost feels like it's ready to fall apart.
I had the option of going back on opioids to manage that pain because it was excruciating.
Catch me in my most vulnerable state.
Sometimes they gave all.
The IED went off and then I was on an adjacent street. My soul left my body and then kind of came back.
My biggest fear is from the combined damage from being in the military, having all the explosions and, you know, the breaching charges and hitting my head on the jumps. And then after that, you know, sparring, fighting, taking big shots.
Yeah, the pituitary is the gland that kind of controls all the hormones. And it's one of the most common things to be damaged in traumatic brain injury.
We went to go see a pain doctor, and that pain management doctor had said, well, he is in a lot of pain. He's going to have something inserted into his spine for the rest of his life.
It was a wake-up call for sure that kind of guided me down the path of getting off all these medications and finding something that was better and a long-term solution. And I was just tired of the rigmarole of these types of medications that I was on for years.
The stem cells took effect very quickly. To go from that to 4 months, and all of a sudden, you know, he's out hiking.
Nerve damage in my left leg has gone down dramatically enough to where, like this weekend, I went rock climbing in Joshua Tree. Yeah, and I felt good, I felt motivated.
And what about everyday Americans?
I was diagnosed with MS. I lost the vision in my left eye. My speech and balance were impaired.
I was diagnosed with ADHD in seventh grade. I was on Ritalin and then Adderall, where I've been on this for 35 years, and it never did anything improve. It just made me have to take more. This is supplying what my body was missing.
And I'm now completely off the diazepam.
I've seen from cancer miracles from people that were told, you know, go home and be with your family.
And we have ALS patients coming in wheelchairs and they're jogging.
To addiction, patients that were just rock bottom.
But here in America, we the people are being used as fuel for profits.
Would it even be considered a conspiracy theory if it's true?
Medicine also is a debate. I love medical debates, but you don't see it anymore.
My eye doctor in Irvine told me, oh, you don't want to know what you're going to look like in 5 years. That's exactly what he told me. You don't want to know what you're going to look like in 5 years. You need to get on methotrexate.
I was really upset with Big Pharma when I found out there is better medicine out there. That is what really pissed me off.
Majority of doctors who are approving a drug have tons of stock in that drug.
Right.
It's wrong, yeah. And for what?
Sometimes I think our leaders kind of get lost in their careers and their own agendas, and they forget, you're a servant. Just like I serve my country, you're a servant. You serve the people. So serve the people.
Conspiracy truth, is that a term that we can use in this scenario?
I just ask, you know, whoever's involved in the FDA, you know, get out of the way, right? Get out of the way and help these people. There's a lot of people that need help right now.
But rather than point the finger at the 800-pound gorillas of big pharma and big insurance,
it's really the insurance companies, the payment system that needs to be updated.
This TV series is going to shine a bright hot spotlight on hope.
It's inspiring, right? It's to have these people out there that challenge the status quo, challenge the system to improve it, to make it better.
Truly advanced medicine would attack illness or injury in the earliest stages, not wait until they become debilitating, chronic, or even deadly.
And it would keep the shelf life longer for our operators. You know, you guys, when they become operators, if they can only make it 7 to 10 years of being, you know, active without falling apart, you know what I mean? If they're gonna invest money, they might as well invest fixing these guys and keeping them healthy mentally and physically so we can, you know, get longer shelf life out of these guys.
Yeah, there's no one that comes out without some kind of scars or damages, whether it's, you know, psychologically or physically. We all have things going on.
This project of information and education is our new mission. Saving a vet or a grandmother saves the whole family.
Had a little girl at 47, and you know, she's 4 years old and is filled with just wonderful energy and this yearning to discover, and I want to be able to be right there.
And we're going to get the word out.
It's hope. I mean, huge hope. I mean, I've got a goal.
Join us in the war of information.
I have goosebumps.
I want to get well. I want to be able to take care of myself.
In the battle for health, help us all be first there.
My heart is back to normality. All my organs work. I'm clear again.
Our physiology, it's miraculous. It's so resilient. It wants to heal.
I am still alive.
My better medicine.